That nodule is pretty much at the base of the mesenteric.
The treatment of colon cancer really depends on the stage of the colon cancer. Colon cancer is divided into four different stages. Stage one would be a small colon cancer that's really localized to the lining of the colon, doesn't involve any nodal involvement. And that would particularly be fine with just surgical resection, and those patients have a great outcome with just surgery alone.
Stage two is when the tumor is a bit bigger, it's invaded into the muscle or more, but still there are no lymph nodes that are positive.
Now for stage three patients, those patients basically have nodal involvement of their cancer. So those patients benefit from surgical resection of the tumor followed by 6 months of chemotherapy. And the goal there is so that we can treat micrometastatic disease, meaning that small cancer cells that are either in the bloodstream or the lymphatics, so that we can reduce the risk of a recurrence.
And stage four is when the tumor has spread to another site, like the liver or the lung. But even in those patients, we used to say this was incurable, and we have found that we've had great success in treating patients with stage four cancers.
We also have other types of agents, what we call biologic agents, that target particular molecular pathways that have been shown to have an important part in stage four colon cancers.
It's a sacrococcygeal tumor.
The main challenges in removing tumors that occur in the colon and the rectum are anatomy based. So patients who have, say, a tumor in the colon, we have to make sure that all the lymph nodes that are associated with that tumor come out. And especially in the rectum, there are more structures that could potentially get injured. So that's why it's really important to have someone who does rectal surgery all the time, someone who's familiar with all the structures, to have an operation where there's minimal effect on any surrounding structures. I think some of the most exciting things are the minimally invasive techniques. So we do most of our operations with laparoscopy, meaning that you get small incisions instead of a big long incision, and we can see up close in ways that we couldn't before. The other big development recently in pelvic surgery, so for rectal cancers, is robotic surgery. And that's been really exciting too, because it really minimizes the size of the incisions, it reduces the length of stay in the hospital after surgery, and also there's a good cosmetic outcome.
After the cancer surgeon is done with removing the tumor, you end up having a space within that area that the tumor was occupying. And that has to be filled with something. That's where a reconstructive plastic surgeon would come in to do that. We try and take tissue from another part of the body and move it into that space to help fill that space, to help prevent that gravitational dependent fall that happens inside the belly.
So he came to see me in January.
As a patient, I think it would be a really great cohesive experience to be seen at the Stanford Cancer Center. And that's because we have the benefit of the tumor board, and this tumor board is a multidisciplinary meeting where we have medical oncologists, and we have colorectal surgeons, we have liver surgeons, we have thoracic surgeons, then we have the pathologists, the radiologists, and nurses, and everyone's talking about, okay, what's the best approach for this person? And we try to come up with a really good, comprehensive, and holistic plan.
I think everyone is at the top of their field here, and we all collaborate well together. We've had many patients who show up on our doorstep that have had tumors that were deemed either unresectable previously or were a lost cause in the past, and we've managed to take care of them. If there's a solution, we'll find it.